Welcome to Control Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain you effects of lead compensator. Now, when we talk about effects of lead compensator, let us try to understand what happens without lead compensator and then with lead compensator what happens. So it will be more clear, like what is that which is happening by lead compensator. So if I say I have input like this and its response is happening like this. Now in this response, if I add lead compensator, then what will happen due to lead compensator? First I'll be drawing this and then I'll explain what are the basics which is happening with this. So you'll be finding this is what the response which one can understand with this lead compensator. Now one thing that is clear, like see previously rise time, that was this. Now rise time with this system, that is this much only. So rise time of lead compensator, that is decreasing. So one thing that is clear from this response, rise time, that will go down, it will decrease. Secondly, one more thing that you can see, maximum peak overshoot. So for if you decrease rise time, maximum peak overshoot, that will increase. So maximum peak overshoot, that will increase. And one thing that even one can see, this is what the response of system. Now after this lead compensator, stability is increasing. So one can say stability increases. So based on this diagram, one can understand this is what with lead compensator. So with lead compensator, rise time goes down, peak overshoot may go up, stability increases, and few more things that I have noted over here. So as I have told, stability increases, bandwidth increases, rise time decreases, response is faster now, and noise enters at high frequencies. Why? The reason is lead compensator is high pass filter. As I have told in last session, you can see my last session where I have derived what is that which is there with lead compensator. So it is high pass filter. So as lead compensator is high pass filter, one can say noise enters into the system at high frequency. So it increases stability, it increases bandwidth even. Rise time goes down, transient response will improve, there could be increase in maximum peak overshoot, and noise enters into the system at high frequency. So these are the effects which is happening due to lead compensator. Thank you so much for watching this video. In next video, I'll be explaining lag compensator. Thank you so much for watching this.